And I'm happy to introduce Vivian Camacho, who is a medical doctor and by profession and a midwife from the heart. With favorable stars, Vivian has traveled different countries and on different continents to support the struggle for the right to health and life with dignity, especially connecting with sages and wise men and women who continue to guard the ancient wisdom. Denouncing Racism is a first look towards understanding and deep respect for the healthy practices of Indigenous people. So from many countries and cultures, Indigenous midwives, men and women have shared common feelings, sorrows, and joys, and strengthening hearts to continue providing love and respect for every life that asks for support. So on that note, I'm honored to introduce Vivian Camacho. Thank you, Vivian. We're glad you're here.
Thank you so much. I am very honored to participate with you, with all people all over the world. And this presentation, Recovering the Sacred Virtual Space from Indigenous Cosmovision and Contra-Hegemonic Interculturality in Health, is based on my personal research and experience from being only an Occidental medical surgeon to becoming a midwife, following my indigenous roots and the vision of my grandmothers and elders alive in my country. I am from the Quechua Nation in the plurinational state of Bolivia. We are indigenous majority. There is wonderful alive ritual practices that take care of life, going beyond racism and common disqualification to this ancient knowledge. We are alive as indigenous communities because of our midwives, parteras and parteros, who assist women wherever they need to be assisted, especially in places with hard access to Western medicine. We need to remark the social determinants of health that are directly linked to the maternal infant's death. That is why we propose our indigenous wisdom as a way of overcoming unfair social structures, to strengthen unite with another peoples of the world that preserve their wisdom despite of colonialism and corporative robbery. Ancient midwifery must be respected according to cultural context in every place in the world. And the main importance about taking care of Mother Earth as the first mother of all. That's why I propose this presentation. Thank you so much for being here. So here we are. The actual situation is birth technification against contra-hegemonic interculturality. With that, I mean, some people are talking about interculturality, about the respectful relationship between cultures, but it has to go beyond only that respect, very cynical. We need to find ways to restructure social justice. I mean, it's not only about talking about respect when there is powerful macroeconomic culture saying that another culture doesn't have the right to exist. I mean, there is only an Occidental culture, capitalist, that is saying indigenous cultures have no worth. So we are fighting against this because, you know, now in the capitalist hegemony, we, as human subjects, have become another community, commodity. It's very sad, circulating in the international market. For example, organ trafficking, human trafficking, cheap labor are examples of what still remains to be seen. So it is urgent consideration for the intercultural and contra-hegemonic movement that forced as a possibility and potential to rebuild and reconstruct from the perspective that we respect life and not only money. I mean, one culture respects money, but another cultures are still respecting life. That's why we are here for. So we confronting question this model of macro-hegemonic dominant culture that respects only the finances and blind worshiping of money. That's why we are seeing, for example, of this worshiping money, the sad situation in Europe, when the banks are being saved and not people, that we propose counter-hegemonic interculturality. And also I have put that social determinant on health because Most people in some conference say those Indios make a woman die, and that's not true, because woman indigenous woman die because they don't have food, they don't have a safe place to stay, they don't have dignity in work. So we have to fight against this. It's not of the mistake of our ancient wives or people all over the world. I mean, it's the woman die during the delivery because unfair social structure. From every village in the world that is still alive, despite centuries of colonization where for centuries cultures have survived, all communities with thousands upon thousands of human beings with their own identities, with their own roots and ways of doing things, living and healing. We propose that the real respect will come after questioning and working on social determinants of own health directly, confronting and challenging situations and living conditions which subject to disease, that only by being born in a country where certain social status, this sentences you to suffer from different disease. So it's not fair. I mean, most indigenous people are poor in their countries because powerful Occidental culture is subjecting them to suffering. They take the land, the water, the food. Also, we see with Monsanto company everywhere, it is poisoning with their transgenic NGOs and their poisons for the earth. So we need to respect again our indigenous roots as well, because life has to be the main point. So we need to get out of this vicious cycle of consumer of Western hegemonic health and medicine, because we have seen it is also a business now. So we need a change of paradigm, a paradigm shift. We have been taught from the Cartesian Newtonian paradigm. I mean, Occidental culture only teaches that there only exists something that I can see now, that I can touch. But our indigenous way of life all over the world, they move inside the quantum holographic paradigm. I mean, quantum physics have already proved this. We move in an energetic world. We move between energetic invisible forces, Mother Earth, Solar Sun, Mother Moon, all universe is alive. So we, as indigenous peoples, we are still taking care of this reconnection with the invisible forces that take care of us. About physiological birth. For example, when you see indigenous women giving birth, most indigenous people, they all always take a natural position. And it's, for example, at the hospital, vaginal birth is not only vaginal birth in this terrible position. And we need to promote a natural birth, because birthing is an involuntary acts, like sleeping, like having an orgasm, is something that our body knows how to do. So most of our indigenous women, they just trust their bodies. I mean, they work hard until the last day of pregnancy, and most are still receiving their babies with their own hands. So we need to restore the ability and confidence in the nature and surrender to it, allow it to happen. So this will facilitate fluid delivery, less intervention possible. At the hospital, there are hard situations, I know, but protocols at the hospital can be timely, but most of them are untimely. I mean, most of them only interfere. As a doctor, I've been working also at hospital, and it is really hard how everyone has to be cutted, everyone has to be with oxytocin, most of it finishes in cesarean sections. And it's really hard in a poor country, in poor countries in the global south, how cesarean rates are so high. That's why we need to change. Essential attitudes that facilitate the delivery, privacy, security, and emotional support that you can find at home. That's why most indigenous women prefer to stay at home. An appropriate environment which is composed by people that, you know, they will love you, they will take care of you. your grandmother, your mother, your midwife, and also your partner. Expression, freedom of expression. You can walk, you can move, you can sing, you can dance. Most of our indigenous rituals have to do also with the singing, with the voice. But at the hospital, you know, people say, oh, woman, say, don't move, just stay quiet. They treat you like if you don't know anything. And most especially, we need freedom to a movement of movement and posture for the function. And if we are at the hospital, at least to look for professional and respectful assistance, not for doctors or nurses that are most of them discriminating indigenous women, and they say those Indians, they give birth like animals. It's so unrespectful in most places yet. So our indigenous wisdom, we have natural processes to address the pain with herbs, with rituals, keeping the environment as warm as possible. That's very important to change. Lithotomy in labor, a questionable practice. It is a paradigmatic element of a healthcare model. This position has to do with the submission of women. I mean, women are still treated like if they don't know what to do, if they lose their authority of their body. When you get into a hospital and get lay down, it's like you don't feel respected. I have researched about this, and it's really sad how women feel very, very intrusive, very not only uncomfortable, but also unrespected. And you see this another beautiful picture. Most indigenous women in shared cultural codes, they think this vertical position like very natural, because the position is also related to female subjugation. This symbolic meaning of position is very important for us, that verticality, that is squatting, because for us, Mother Earth, here the land, you know, gravity force, Mother Earth is calling the baby. So you know you are giving birth alone, because Mother Earth is helping you to your baby get down, and she is also giving you your force to deliver. So we need to reencounter again this beautiful force, reconnect with that. Yeah, you see this picture? Who is helping who? Here the doctor is on his knees receiving the baby, and it's from a different old picture, but you know now in our hospitals it's really different. So now for whom is convenient to stand up, for the doctor, or is convenient for the woman to lay down? I mean, we need to be sensitive and recover our verticality or our freedom of movement during birth. You see this position? In this drawing, she is taking a row. Sometimes it is a mat or something you put on the ceiling, and it's really easy. And then it is a drawing from Mayan culture also, from indigenous costumes. And you see also that the German painter, I found this drawing, there is also a vertical position in this building chair. And this more ancient, also a building chair and vertical position. So vertical position has been natural all over the human history. Now, I love the researchers from Michael Oden, Michel Oden, who has found so beautiful examples. And these have moved me as a doctor to feel strength that midwifery must be respected. The first hour after birth is a critical period in our development of the ability to love. We must take care of it. For example, the hormones that are produced during a beautiful birth, oxytocin is always present, endorphins, prolactin. It's a cocktail of hormones, and Michael Oden says. Oxytocin is found in any aspect of love in men and women, also in the breast milk. It releases more easily in the hip. It stimulates uterine contractions and is inhibited by the neocortex. I mean, we must become very, very intuitive inside our bodies without letting anyone tell us what to do, what to say, how to breathe. No, we just need to get inside. For a beautiful building, we just let woman do what she knows what to do. But adrenaline is always fighting against oxytocin. It is good for us when we need to escape. It is good for us when we are scared and need to protect us. But adrenaline, when it's produced during this, it just causes the stopping of breathing and, you know, the problems after that. So in a beautiful environment, when you feel loved with your midwife, your doula, at your home or a place that you feel safe, oxytocin is very easily released. And in our indigenous tradition, we take care a lot of heating, and heating also promotes oxytocin. We do a beautiful stem bath with aromatic herbs, beautiful ones like chamomile, rosemary, sage, and it smells so nicely and also helps getting the perineum very soft so we can go on with the birth. It's very beautiful what we still know. Our indigenous midwives, they didn't know about hormones, they didn't know about what quantum physics had come. They knew it because of their experience and connection in life. So you see this beautiful painting of Alex Way, how everything is a natural process, energetic natural process from the beginning. So we are energetic beings. Life is so much magical than we have ever learned. And most of our indigenous cultures are still preserving that wisdom. But it's because of racism and discrimination they are suffering. That's why I stand for our ancestral midwifery. And you know that options for Occidental woman, we all have, all women in the world have the right to deliver wherever we want. That picture has been taken in Brazil. They have do the mantra for birth at home, and most women are now organizing. So also for Occidental women that go beyond the siege of the hospital, go beyond the authority that don't respect her, they are getting organized all over the world, and we have our choices in Western cultures, building in water and building at home. And also, you see that beautiful midwives organizations all over the world, like this organization now, but also we have to continue fighting for the right to be wherever we want, with whomever we want, because it is a very beautiful, sacred moment. That's why we have our midwives, our ancient midwives, the midwives all over the world from the culture. We have ancient little statues all over that always show a woman in verticality and also being helped by someone. And this, you see this beautiful, is a Mapuche. She is taking her pulse, and by her pulse, she can know if the woman, most midwives know here in the Andes, if the woman delivered a soon, if the baby is breech, or if whatever is going, is happening, they know. It's very wonderful how they work. These are beautiful midwives from Oaxaca, from Mexico. And these are in Mexico, they are very organized. In Mexico also, they have their organizations, but we need to continue promoting that organization. And you know, here in this another one, and they are making the mesa. They are making the offering for Pachamama, because it's very important. Those are midwives from Peru. And here we see the picture of Quechua midwives here in Titicaca Lake, where I have learned from them the rituals that we have as Andean culture. They are very wise women to know how to resolve problems when they emerge. And also my heart was taken by this beautiful group of Maya midwives in Guatemala. This is me, and this is my partner from People's Health Movement. And we have gone together to meet those amazing Maya midwives. Most of them wouldn't even speak Spanish. They only speak their language. And they have survived to the killings in the 90s. Because being indigenous was kind of a thing. The army would follow them and kill them. But they have survived as a culture because they have the rituals of healing. Our healing rituals include healing your pain, healing your heart, healing what you feel. So it is also part of, in this building, Mayan building house, they take care of ancient, with ancient wisdom of the pregnant woman. Every consultation is a beautiful ritual, and also the day of the birthing day is an amazing ritual with the grandfather fire talking with the ancestors, because you know we are not alone. We have come from a line of people. Those are our ancestors. So we call on them for their help and also for that magnificent force that has given us life. And those are beautiful culture in Peru, in the Titicaca Lake, and in Taquile, and they have preserved also the healing wisdom, which is, includes also building. I mean, healing health is more than thinking about hospitals, thinking about pills. It's a way of life. We need to have dignity in life, to not to live with humiliation. I mean, to have a proper house, to be respected where we work, to have food, to have water, that is also health. So I have met all those wonderful people, and I know they are also fighting to preserve their rights because corporations are taking the land, the water. So we need to stand together, because otherwise all of us will continue being part of that sad model of life, of that model of Western culture that only respects money. And you know, in different cultures, I have found goddesses of childbirth. I'm making actually a research, and this is a Mayan goddess, Ixchel. She is the goddess of fertility, of also the knitting and the mother of water. She is very cold during birth. And this is from an ancestor I have found also in Ireland, this beautiful drawing that shows how modern life, an ancient power, feminine power, is taking care of us. And this is a goddess I have found from Greece. This is another goddess of building that I have found in Japan. And this is also another goddess I have found in pre-Christian cultures. And those goddesses of building have always been part of us as human beings. I mean, we are not alone doing our things. We are always surrounded by an invisible force, very beautiful, that is taking care of us. We can call it in different names, we can call it in different cultures or different things, but the fact is that building is a sacred act. That's why we have goddesses of childbirth in every culture that has preserved their knowledge, because we know we are not alone and we can call on their help. I know that maybe I have saying something very strange for someone, but you know, a midwife is only a channel. Midwife is only someone who is channeling that energy and who is helping. But when you know in your heart that you are surrendered and protected by that beautiful force, and everything goes just right there. I have a conclusion reflection, and I know that we have come from different cultures, different way of seeing things, way of seeing life, but it has to be also with the respect of who we are. The wisdom of our ancestors are still alive in different places in the world, and you know, our indigenous healers, our indigenous midwives, they do the best possible to take care of life with what they have. So, go to another and from the other is not an intellectual problem. It is a heartful problem, a problem from the heart. Of course, we have to study the another one. It is a must do, it's an obligation. But to understand is something different. Knowing the life of the people, to make the necessary question that leads to knowledge. Scientific knowledge doesn't come out but from the heart of the brother or sister. Only then it is possible for people to escape their own world and to go into another world. Otherwise, you may go and return but without understanding. Satan hurts that give life because you imagine that they are weak. The feeling the earth because you see it as a business, or violating water with your indifference. You can go to many worlds, but if the heart is not ready, we will not see anything. I mean, all this magical wisdom has been alive, causing a lot of blood, a lot of killing in different cultures. Because, you know, in Europe, so millions have died because they were considered witches. Also here in indigenous regions, most of our healers were killed because they were considered witches. But it's not witchcraft. Quantum physics is proving for Western model of life that there exists more than we see, that we are energetic beings into an energetic, beautiful life force, which we call Pachamama, which we call our first mother. And when we poison our mother, we won't have health, we won't have food, we won't have water. So how can we live if we poison our mother? So that this is also a reflection that we must take care of life as a whole. And also, when we talk about goddesses of birth, it's like every woman becomes a beautiful goddess because we are part of that huge, huge force. So we need to reconsider this and recover the sacred birth space as a human right for every woman in this world. Our babies have the right to be received with tender, with love, in safe environment, respecting where we come from, respecting what we are. So I encourage you to go from one heart to another heart, to find different worlds, and to reconnect with that invisible forces that take care of us. Whatever you name it, they are always taking care of us, and it is the force of our ancestors. We didn't have come from nothing. We come from our beautiful lineage of grand-grandmothers, grand-grandfathers that are still taking care of us, like we want to do for the ones that are coming. This is the bibliography. If someone is interested, can contact me. And thank you so much. These flowers are for you. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Vivian. What a beautiful, wonderful presentation. Many appreciative comments have been made in the text box as well. So now we can certainly take some time for people to ask some questions and or make additional comments. And let me see here. I'm not so sure that there was any specific questions, just lots of impressive comments.
Actually, I am very, very honored to participate. Thank you all that have been listening. Thank you all for taking the time for hearing me. I know I am I always consider myself like a little aunt, like a little hormiguita, because we are millions that are working on this earth to get this world a little bit better, and especially midwives. Midwives all over the world are the sacred guardians of life, are the sacred guardians of this world for become a little bit better. And it can be achieved only with a strong heart, with love in the heart, love for life. So thank you so much. So I will continue responding your questions. I see Vivian.
Thank you again.
I will respond a little comment.
Does anybody have a particular question for Vivian? I see
there's
lots
some great
and
questions.
Lots
yeah, in the chat. So maybe Vivi can answer some of those. That'd be great. And I think she was heading towards.
I'm just reading the wonderful comments you do. I see here some questioning. Ginger says, any ideas on how we translate this empowering and education woman? I mean, it comes from your heart, Ginger. You need to reconnect with your ancient lineage. You come from beautiful ancient lineage, no matter where we are in the world. So we can reduce the fear because it's reconnecting in the wisdom of our body. And here Teresa says, how do you call upon your goddess when you attend a woman? It's a beautiful ritual that we do with our brother fire, with our help, and especially the days, if it's the day, during the day or during the night. We have specific rituals, beautiful ones. And this is still alive in my country. Most America Latina is full of an ancient indigenous wisdom. That's why we need to face racism, face discrimination. Because our ancient elders, they know a lot of beautiful wisdom that is being improved now by quantum physics. I do attempt build, and I also support a lot home building. And I was trained and I've learned meeting and traveling all over different places to meet those beautiful midwives, parteras and parteros. And if anybody has any question, anyone wants to say something. And I will activate my camera to show what I am wearing. Actually, now I have decided to wear this floppy hat. This is from my grandmother. And also, we wear like that in most indigenous places in Bolivia. And I have decided to wear this because they give me strength. Because I know that our grandmothers in the world have taken care of the world for us. So everyone deserves a beautiful future for the children and their grandchildren. And also coming from the indigenous Quechua nation, I know that it's very important to connect to the earth. Maybe a lot of has been lost, but we need to reconnect with what is still alive. We need to reconnect with that ancient wisdom. Griselda Simonelli from Argentina is a beautiful friend. And she says how to promote this wisdom from where we are in the world. Griselda, tenemos que conectarnos desde donde estamos con la luna, con la tierra, con nosotras, con nuestros cuerpos, respetando nuestras menstruaciones incluso. We need to connect with our bodies. Our body is part of Mother Earth, is a little part of that little huge body. And also respecting our bodies, respecting our menstruations in ritual cycles. And menstruating is very sacred for women. It starts all over there. When we are teaching, since we are little children, that menstruation is awful, that being a woman is so hard because we won't get very well paid, we will be violated, we will be raped or whatever. If a woman raises in that environment, we need to heal that wound. It has also a lot to do with pregnancy. That's why we have our ritual fires to heal our pain, to heal our whatever is hurting inside our heart. If anybody has any comments?
It does look like there were many questions if you looked back in the chat, Vivian. Not so sure you were able to answer all of them. You've been invited to speak at ICM. What an honor. did you see all of the questions? There was one from Lemon Clark. Yes, I did see that one up there earlier. Yeah.
I see a question, Lennon Clark, that Bolivia supports the Quechua indigenous midwife. Actually, my president is indigenous, My president Evo Morales, he comes from the Aymara Nation, and he is supporting a lot with the indigenous the traditional ministry, and it is also supporting a lot in health. But you know, gringos don't like him. U.S. government doesn't like him because he is fighting for the rights of the people, of the most abandoned people. And you know, racism has a lot to do still with our medical colleges in Bolivia, so we need to fight against it. And our government is supported a lot because we are indigenous majorities. Also, coming back to these beautiful experiences, since we have some more time left, actually this presentation I give in different places where I get invited, and it takes me about 1 hour and 1 hour and a half because of different technical little issues that I also see. But I want to offer you a gift that I have received from this. From our Quechua midwife, I have learned from them. I was with them in 2006, but then I have found also very huge inspiration in the Mayan midwife, and you know, for our indigenous wisdom, when your heart is sad, it is not normal. When you are sad or depressed, it's not natural. I mean, sometimes it's like when you're sad, you have to go to work, you have to continue doing your things. In Western culture, they don't respect how you feel. But in our indigenous cultures, when your heart is sad, when you're feeling pain, you must feel this. You must have joy in your heart. That is a healthy situation. So I have learned from this beautiful ancient elder midwife Mayan from the Maya culture that when my heart is sad, I don't go to attend this, she said. I send somebody else. Because you know, from your heart, it comes the really strength for being there. You have, I don't know if you have heard about toroid outcomes. Quantum physics is showing that our heart has a toroid outcome, very beautiful. Our heart is sending the signals to the brain so we can go on in life. But when your heart is sad or disturbed, everything gets lost. So I have learned from this beautiful Mayan elder that when my heart is sad, I cannot go to attend any wedding. I must be strong and happy to go there with love, with care. The energy of love that has been so subestimated. We are human beings because we need to be loved. And the love for life that is that will continue, that will help us to want to continue being alive. I have seen in Europe such high rates of suicide. It is so sad how people have lost that connection with love for life. It has to do with building. It has to do how we are received in this world. If we want to heal those sad wounds in the world, we need to heal their spirits. Because very things are hurting now. Palestine hurts. And it's hurting the world everywhere. Africa hurts hugely. And it hurts also how companies take the water of our indigenous people, how mining companies are taking them. We need to preserve that love for life, and it starts in building. That's why I have decided to share with this with you. And please, that little gift as a midwife to another midwife that are listening, please feel that you are very supported, that you are very loved, and that you are very necessary for this world.
Do you see the question, Vivian, about do you feel that when you learn from the traditional midwifery is enough, or would it be good to feel
it with medical midwifery training?
You know, so much. I am a surgeon doctor. Also, I have studied part in Bolivia and part in Belgium, and I have seen huge differences. Not only as a doctor I support this, but especially as a midwife. And I have decided to recover my ancient roots because I have seen that this is also effective and tender and patient care. What I have learned as a doctor at the university while attending this, when I was learning as a doctor, I say, I don't want to come to a hospital so they can cut me and they pinch me and they don't respect me. That's why I decided to follow my roots. I know it has to do a lot also with racism. That's why I felt so necessary to share this presentation with you. Thank you so much for the ones that have taken interest in this. Of course, medical occidental services are good for emergencies, are good for saving lives when it's necessary. But we see now an epidemic of cesarean, and in such poor places, poor countries, which it's indecent. It's not moral to see huge cesarean rates just only because of the money of the private sector and also the money that is extended in cesarean. That's why we need to promote also our indigenous wisdom that is, it's not not for a business. I have been also in Chiapas with midwives, and wherever I have met our midwives, they work because it is a calling from your heart. It is a calling that life is giving you. If you don't feel your heart, things are not going to be good, and we know that. And I have learned from them that work of midwifery or healer of a shaman from your community is a service calling. And you do not do it for money. You do it because you love your community. You love your people. That is what is lost in Western culture. That is what is lost in universities. That's why I encourage you to follow your heart also. I encourage women that are not midwives also to become doulas. You can go with a tender hand to say some another woman, oh my dear sister, please be calm, everything is going to be good, don't be afraid. Here we are women supporting another woman. Our wounded uterus, they need to be healed. There is a lot of raping. Do you see the news in India? Raping is such a common thing, and also in our countries, raping has become such horrible thing. We need to feel that with our uterus, with our support from woman to woman. If I heal my womb with my womb tender and with my loving womb, I will go to another woman to say, oh my dear sister, you can do that, please. Whatever you have suffered, it can be healed, and we can heal this with love. And I have seen that at hospitals, you also feel very unrespected and wounded sometimes. That's why our midwives must be respected and encouraged to go on, and also to you all. We need to heal our woman wounds. We need to heal whatever that has been hurting us, so we can pass this fire from heart to heart. That is why our indigenous wisdom is still alive, because it has come from heart to heart. Our elders take care of it to pass this from heart to heart.
Vivian, you continue to inspire many people on your presentation with your passion and your heart and your commitment. And with that, I thank you immensely. Do you feel like you have covered everything you wanted to discuss? I know you could go on.
I invite you all to regain this trusting, to regain that feeling that we are not only what we think, we are more than we think, we are spiritual beings with a beautiful body. We are spiritual beings that are working in this life, interconnected one another. That's why we need to retake the sense of community, human community. Our indigenous communities have preserved this. It's very sad how to see Western modern culture shows us as individualism as the only way of life. That is not true. We are not born to be alone. We need the contact. We need embraces. We need huge to be hugged, to be loved. That's why we encourage our building processes to be more loving, more tender. That's why we encourage babies to be put in the arms of their mothers immediately. Please, I encourage you all to look for your ancestral lineage, but also look for the wisdom of Earth. If we take care of Earth, everything's going to be good. Everything's going to be good for us, healthy and beautifully building a life. Here we call it Tsumach Kautai. Tsumach Kautai is the way of living the most beautiful possible in the most beautiful way. So I invite you all to live in the most beautiful possible way. That's why we will be able to change things, even though if we feel small or alone or whatever, but you know that we are millions walking in this life that want to take care of life, that with that little grain of beauty put in this world today, that will help. So I encourage you, please, that feel very, very loved, especially midwives in the world. We need more midwives, but it is for healing our entire world. It's not only a movement for a midwifery movement, it is for life. It is for entire life that is very wounded now. And we need to heal that wound with the strength of our hearts, with the tender and loving tender care of our hearts. It is very powerful. Thank you so much.
Your passion is showing through. There is one question here from Mel. She says, it is hard to maintain and preserve that undisturbed birth path which allows free flow of hormones in a hospital environment. Midwives often are hand-tied with documentation and policy. Any suggestions for making the thousands of midwives working in hospitals? And we only have a couple of minutes.
Yes.
So.
For this, I have seen that working in Belgium, I have seen our midwife, the trained university midwife, that also have to fulfill schedules, they have to fulfill the hospital time, like the doctors. But it is not based on the mother's time, on the baby's unique time. We need to gain respect to organize and say again that every woman is unique and must be respected in their time. That's why we have high rate cesareans, because no one has the time and patience to stay beside a woman, helping her, taking care of her, no matter if it takes 8 hours, 10 hours, 1, 2, 3 days. We need to go organize and stand up for the right of respect our time, our body's time. It is so disconnected in Western culture, maybe they won't understand at first, but if we unite and if we gain more women to be respecting their bodies, respecting their time, they will have to hear us. So I advise you to organize and pass this fire, respecting our lives, our times, our bodies, one by one. So we need to organize and make it listen to Western medical culture.
Thank you again, Vivian. I'm now going to turn the recording